welcome to This Epic Disaster. How are you? It's been a while. We did take a week off. We're back.
We only took 1 week off. Calm
am I
down.
Too excited about being
yes,
back?
Yes, calm
well,
down.
Well, I kind of felt, you know, every time, we haven't taken a lot of time off, but sometimes we've had a little bit of a delay or something. And I always feel out of sync when I do that. Like when we come back, I always feel like that something's not right.
I can never remember what we talked about on the last show.
I never remember that anyway.
I mean, I rarely do, but it just feels like we did a show so long ago that I honestly don't know what we talked about.
That's what I feel like. I do feel like it was a long time ago. But so what happened was you came over last week. We were going to do a show and you came over and neither of us really were mentally up for doing a show. And we were like, let's don't do a show.
I was just exhausted.
I was too.
I'm still exhausted.
I am too.
But I mean... You know, it's
I'm physically exhausted right now, but yeah. I was mentally exhausted. I didn't have the stuff. I felt like if we did a show, we'd sit here and nothing would have been funny. We would have droned on, you know, like we do all the time.
Like, I can't say that we won't do that today.
We do it all the time. It is our show.
It's what we do.
Thanks for everybody who's listening. You know, this is weird. I didn't know this would happen, but our downloads are like 50% off.
Yeah.
And I don't mean like in a sale.
They're just like
they're
not.
They're 50% off.
Yay.
No, we're getting like 50% less downloads. I thought when people were out of like their business, out of work or whatever, they'd be home, they'd be listening to podcasts all the time.
But they're, and I, like I told you earlier, I don't think that's the case because people's routines have been basically turned upside down. And for instance, when I listen to my shows or my books, I do it on the car or in the car on my way to and from work. So if I'm not spending and I haven't been spending time in the car and oh my God, a gallon or a tank of gas lasted me a month.
Yeah,
that is insane.
But, well, not only that, but filling up now because gas is so cheap. You could do that. And it's
I'll have to now. But but again, I haven't listened to any of my books or shows or anything since we've been working from home or working remotely because my routine is upended.
Well, so I want to thank people who do listen. Please keep listening.
Please keep listening.
Don't stop listening. No, I understand my podcast listening kind of is off a little bit.
But that's because you're working, isn't it?
Yeah, a little bit. But I mean, it just happens. It's the way it goes. But thanks to everybody who continues listening to us. We will try to continue to be entertaining. And we're always open for suggestions and we're always open for beer. We always want new beer. And we have a new beer this week.
We have a new beer
on our
here.
Live beer review.
Yes, we do.
And it's a beer that we're both very afraid of.
I'm not going to say I'm afraid of it because
I'm not. Saying it.
I'm going to say I just don't think I'm going to like it. What I do either. Like is it's from the Burnt Hickory Brewery out of Kennesaw,
you know
Georgia.
What? I'll tell you the entire reason I don't like it.
Why?
The can is green. That's the entire... There's nothing else on it that makes me think I won't like it. It says IPA. I'm not an IPA fan necessarily. I've had a little bit. But for some reason, I thought it was called Hoppy Hopperton or something. There are some pictures of hops on it. That's one thing.
Yes, there are pictures of hops on
it. I just feel
it.
Like it's going to be too hoppy and I don't like hoppy beers.
But there's also... Okay, so this is a Drivin and Cryin
Do you
beer.
Like them? Do you like that song?
I do.
I mean, the band?
I do.
I don't know enough about them. I've heard a little bit about them.
Yeah, I mean, what I've heard. I like. But this is Straight to Hell Mystery Road.
Wow, that sounds good.
And it's 5.5% alcohol. And it is
could be better.
Considered an IPA.
Okay. Well, let's try it. Let's crack this.
Let me read this. I want to
read
what
it crack this
says.
Mofo
here.
Open.
Thank you.
Try. Oh, now you're going to have one eye that's one strength and another eye another strength.
This is weird. You gave me glasses
me.
That don't work.
It's perfect for me. I made those myself.
Okay. So it says, I grew up just west of the tracks holding me back around your door. She's calling out my name. That must be lyrics from the song.
Oh, from Drivin' and Cryin.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, interesting. So it's named after one of their songs. See, I don't know enough about the band to know that it's named after one of their songs.
Okay. I just smelled it.
You
can.
Dealt it and smelt it. All right, so this is we could say it's the golden color.
It is. It's an
sort
IPA.
Of golden.
So
I feel like it was going to be very green. It is. It's got a little bit of a green.
People
tint
know
to
what
it.
Color IPA is. It's gold. It's pretty. It looks kind of like hazy lemonade.
Yeah. It already has a scent. It's very, what do you call it?
Odorific?
It's got a big odor. Like Mr. Rogers.
Like Mr. Rogers. Did you know?
We were talking about this before we started.
I want everyone listening to know that one of the things that Mr. Rogers, the actual person, Mr. Rogers, would do.
The actual mister.
To make his wife laugh is fart in public.
He would fart. And that would make her laugh whenever, like, they were in a social situation that was, like, they were in church or something that was boring. He would fart to make her laugh.
Yeah.
Mr. Rogers did that.
Mr. Rogers. I mean, farts are funny.
They're funny, but I don't want anybody doing it. Like, I don't want my wife coming up to me and farting to be funny.
No.
Now, if she did it accidentally, I would just ignore it. I would pretend like, because, you know. I would
laugh and point.
Well, I know, but I don't like that. I feel like I would do what I would want other people doing if I did it.
Just ignore it.
But I know people who will just go up and fart in their spouse's face. They don't care.
It's like, you know, what comes out of your ass does not need to go in my nose.
So this smells, speaking of going in the nose, this smells very citrusy.
Mm-hmm.
Smells very grapefruity.
Mm-hmm. I just tasted it.
All right.
It's a classic IPA.
I'm going to try it.
It's not
overly. Very grapefruit. Very, very grapefruity.
It's not overly hoppy. It's not overly grapefruity. It's not overly citrusy.
Okay.
But it's just, it's an IPA.
It tastes like grapefruit juice. All right. So we'll be sucking on this beer. We'll tell you what we think at the end of the podcast, as we always do on our live beer reviews.
Yes, we will.
What was I going to say? Oh, daggone it. We were just talking right at the beginning and I forgot. No, I don't remember.
Wow.
So how's your week been going? What's going on with you? You're not going to work.
I'm not. I take that back.
You're going to work.
Right.
You're just not going to your office.
Right. I'm working remotely now and have been. Let's see. Okay, so today is day 30.
What?
Of basically not leaving the house.
You've been working home 30 days?
Yep.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No. Let's do that to the whole podcast. I didn't think it was that long.
Yeah, so really. Today is day 30 of basically not leaving the house.
Mm-hmm.
It is, tomorrow will be day 21 of actually working remote, like
wow.
Work day.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's crazy. I did the math, and I did it properly.
Have you adjusted? Because you were really stressed out about it.
I hate working from home.
I love it.
Despise it.
That's what I do.
That's what you do. But
my job.
I'm a collaborator. Mm-hmm. I'm the kind of person that needs to get up and go talk to somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And I need to, if I'm talking to you about something important that I need done or that I'm trying to understand from you,
mm-hmm.
I need to look you in the eyes when I talk to you.
Right.
And I need to see your face and I need to see that I have your attention. Does that make sense?
Sure.
So when you're just, you know, IMing
mm-hmm.
or on a phone call, I don't know if I have your full attention.
Yeah.
So, you know, it just feels like communication breaks down when you can't look somebody in the face. So, you know, that for me is probably the biggest thing. The other thing is that prior to all this happening, I didn't have a proper work setup, but I do now. And I think I mentioned it on podcast.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had to go into the office and pick up a few things so that I could turn it into a proper desk, workstation.
Well, now I have a couple of criticisms about or aimed toward you. So now I've done like 3 or 4 live videos on the This Epic Disaster page, and I encourage people to go check them out. The last one I did, I was actually for my workshop in Chattanooga. So you get a little tour, a mini tour of the workshop. Sorry, I spit on you. I should wear my mask. My workshop in Chattanooga, and you get to see little sculpture stuff.
Yeah.
And so it's sort of an insight into my work.
It's fun.
It is. And I've done some other live things through This Epic Disaster, and you've done zero. You haven't done any.
I haven't.
And I feel like you should. I think people need to see some of your situation. You don't have to, you don't have to video yourself pooping or showering or anything like that.
That's helpful.
No one
Thank
needs
you.
To see that. But I mean, just, you know, maybe do a little, even if it's a little 30-second video. We want an insight into your life, too.
I mean, I get that. But you know what else I haven't done?
Showered?
I haven't. I barely. I shower like every other day or every third day.
I think everybody's into that right now.
I've also not decluttered the house like I said I was going to.
Right.
I've not cleaned out my closet.
It's like here. You know, you see my studio. You just, it's how you aim the camera. You don't have people. You don't have to show people everything.
I'm just saying my motivation level is very low right now.
Yeah.
Very low. Like it's work for me to take my dog out on my lunch break or a walk.
Mm-hmm.
And I enjoy that. That's something that I enjoy doing, and I know she needs it. But it's still it's like a struggle just to put clothes on. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's hard for me to even get the gumption. Like, nobody wants to see this. Nobody wants to see my face. And I
don't think that that's true.
And I can't think of anything to say anyways, because I literally can barely think of things to say to my dog.
Just do a short video of you walking your dog.
I mean, I could do that. Maybe I'll
do
that tomorrow.
My situation, as you know, I work from home a lot. About half the time I work from home. But I do have a studio. So I live in Atlanta. My studio's in Chattanooga. Now, I have employees that work in the studio in Chattanooga. I don't access that all the time. But I do on a regular basis. So I have to go up to Chattanooga, mm-hmm. which is a two-hour drive from here, on a fairly regular basis.
Mm-hmm.
And then when we're doing a project, which is right now, 2 to 3 times a week I have to do it. That's a 2-hour drive.
Yeah.
One way.
And that's crazy.
A pain in the butt.
That's
but anyway, it's got to be done. And but this is weird because I'm working from home and then I go up to do big sculptures. Now, I do sculptures in styrofoam, and this is what I show on the video. If you want to see it, you mm-hmm. can watch it. And I've done some on my Facebook page. I think I did one on Instagram or something like that. So if you want to see any of these kind of things, you can. Large sculptures, and they're out of styrofoam, so they're really, really messy.
Yeah, very messy.
And the big workshop up there, it's fun to work in, and you can get messy. It doesn't matter. So, So I've got some employees that don't want other people mingling with them.
Exactly.
Which I understand, but we have a really large facility, and we generally don't work in the same room. So I kind of feel like maybe some people are like a little too paranoid. I understand that, but I just feel like you're working in different rooms. What are the chances,
you know?
But who knows what the chances are? But anyway, I'm taking steps. The employees are taking steps. So I don't feel like we're really at danger. I don't have tons of employees.
Right.
So because of this, to kind of make the employees' situation better, I'm trying to do a lot of my work from home.
Mm-hmm.
And my home studio is really small. It used to be my garage.
Right.
And I converted it. And so I don't have a lot of room for sculpture. So it's really tight.
Especially not the larger pieces that you're doing.
And it's very, very messy.
Very messy.
So, but anyway, I did some today, and I did a live sculpture of a chicken. Today.
It's a super cute
Easter
chicken.
Sunday.
It's a super cute chicken.
And so you can watch it if you want to. It's 2 hours long. I would suggest you speed it up or just kind of watch some of the highlights.
Did you realize it was going to be two? Or did you know that?
I've done a few where I was just like kind of show progress or something. So I thought, well, I'm going to do one where I just start it from the beginning. And then people can come in and watch a little bit and then leave and come back if they want. I knew people wouldn't. I think there might be one or two people who watched the whole thing.
Wow.
Or stuck around. But I knew nobody's going to watch all of it.
Sure.
But it's interesting to see. So it starts with just a block of styrofoam
mm-hmm.
and then chicken comes later.
And then you have chicken.
Now you know which comes first, chicken or the egg. It was the chicken.
Chicken or the block of styrofoam.
That's right. So, but yeah, that's the big thing is like, you know, stuff that I used to do up there and I'm going to have to do some stuff up there. I end up have to do here.
Ugh.
So that's my big change, but everything else mostly in my life is kind of the same.
Well, yeah, because you don't regularly go somewhere, like you were saying.
That's right.
Would you like to play a game of Would You Rather?
I would rather play a game of Would You Rather.
Okay, let's do that.
Let's play a game of Would You Rather. Who's going to go first?
Well,
this every weekend, or every week. It's a game of Would You Rather. You drop a color stone, you get a question corresponds with that color, which is blue this week. Would you rather miss the winning shot for the high school state basketball championship or misplace a $10,000 winning lottery ticket?
I would much rather miss the shot.
Me too.
Because
the whole rest of your life, you would be like looking for that damn ticket.
No question. Exactly.
Yeah.
No, I mean, I don't even have to think about
that.
What
would you do with $10,000 if you won it? I mean,
right now?
Do you know how fast that would go? People think, oh, that's big. But $10,000 really wouldn't last.
My bills are more than $10,000.
That's what I'm saying.
I have more than $10,000 in credit card debt right now.
Yeah.
So I would just pay my credit
card. $10,000, you remember when I mean, that just sounds like a lifetime's worth of money. But it's like it would go in a month.
It's nothing. I mean, that wouldn't pay my rent.
We both dropped blue today.
For a year.
Blue.
That wouldn't pay my rent for 10 months.
No.
All right. So you got blue as well. So your blue question is, would you rather wet your pants in front of your work colleagues?
Okay.
Or.
Like I haven't.
Be caught picking your nose and eating it.
Be caught by who?
It doesn't say.
Ooh, that's a weird one.
I mean, you don't eat it when you pick your nose.
Not anymore.
You did when you were younger.
Yeah, I ate everything when I was younger. but how do you, I mean, here's the thing. Your body makes it. I mean, it's your body. It's going in your body. It's already in your body. It's in your body. You pull it out. You put it back in your body.
Are you justifying eating boogers?
No, I'm just saying that's what happens. So what's the big deal?
Okay.
I mean, it's already there in your body.
Here's the difference between these two options is if I saw my coworker wet themselves, mm-hmm. I would have compassion for them and uh-huh. want to see if there's something wrong with them medically mm-hmm. and can I help you?
If they're eating a booger,
they're
hungry.
If I see someone picking their nose money. And eating it. They
were, give them a sandwich.
I would because give them they're, something to eat.
Yeah. Yeah, I do feel like, I don't know. I think you would get more sympathy if you wet your pants, so maybe I'd do that.
Yeah.
What if you're wearing a kilt?
Well, you'll still have a puddle underneath you.
I know, but nothing gets wet. So that would be the best option.
Okay.
Speaking of kilt, you know, so I found out this week that sport kilt is making masks. Now everybody's making masks.
Yes.
I mean, the other kilt companies are doing it as well.
Yes.
But sport kilt is making masks, and I ordered them. So I got two for me and one for you.
You got me one?
One in your tartan, brown tartan,
mm-hmm.
And then two for me. I got a Wallace and a McDonald. My two tartans, family tartans.
That's
so
exciting.
Waiting for them to show up.
Thank you.
And
for
I'm
that.
Hoping that the virus sticks around long enough so that I could use them.
Did you just say that out loud?
Yeah, I would really hate for my mask to show up and then the virus is over.
Okay,
everybody gets
the
to
thing.
Go back out.
When Nurse CJ was here,
uh-huh.
she straight up told us that the masks that you're using
yeah.
aren't going to help you not get the virus.
That's not what it's for.
It's to stop you from spreading.
That's right. Me talking just now and I spit over there.
Yeah.
If I had a mask on, it wouldn't happen. So it's for your protection. Me wearing a mask is for your protection, not mine.
Right.
But and that's very valuable. So
I agree.
I wear my mask out in public. It's funny. My wife and I, we've gone shopping a couple of times and we're both wearing masks.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of interesting. I never thought that when we got married. It's like one day we'll shop with masks on.
I haven't worn a mask when I go out.
I asked my wife the other day, I was like, don't you think that people who aren't wearing masks are basically saying, screw you, everybody? Because it's like they can wear masks. They're either saying, I don't believe this is real, or I believe it's real, but I'm not going to do anything about it. I'm not going to do anything to protect you.
Or they're saying, I don't have a mask.
Anybody, you will have a mask, but you can make a mask. They're very easy. I can give you one. But I'm going to give you one because I just bought one. So, but it's helpful. And it's one of the things that I kind of wish we would keep doing after the virus passes.
You just never want anybody to go out of the house without a mask on ever again?
Yeah, hide your face.
Hide your face.
But can you imagine, though, let's say 6 months ago, if you walked into Walmart with a mask on, they would make you take it off.
Well, I just read in the news this past week, they made somebody take their mask off.
That's so weird.
At a grocery store.
Well, I mean, it's illegal in some cities for a grown-up person to wear a mask.
Yeah, and you can't, I mean, if your bank doesn't offer mobile banking and you have to go to the bank,
yeah.
you are not allowed to obscure your face in a bank.
I did. I went to the bank. So this is weird. I went to the bank and I had to,
my card. Compromised my card.
Oh, really?
And I think they paid their phone bill with it.
Really?
I get this like weird charge. Almost $300 to AT&T.
Oh my gosh, no.
Yeah, and I don't use AT&T for anything.
Right.
I don't have an AT&T thing. So I had to cancel my card,
mm-hmm.
and then I had to go get another one.
Did you get the $300 back?
Yes.
Okay,
they
good.
Refunded that.
Okay, good.
Because it was caught in time. It was pending, so it hadn't cleared yet, so I caught it. So it had cleared that pending that morning.
Mm-hmm.
So I called. I was like, wow, AT&T? I don't have anything AT&T.
Yeah.
So I called the bank, and they were like, yeah, it just happened this morning. And I was like, cancel it. So they canceled my card. So then I had to go to the bank, and I had to order another card. So a couple of things on that. First of all, I did go in with a mask, but the branches are not open. You have to make an appointment to go.
Right.
And so I had to call and say, I want to come inside. And they had to, so they ask you these questions before you come in. They're like, have you been to New York or New Jersey? Have you been out of the country? They asked you all these questions, like screening questions, before they let you come in.
Yeah. 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 I understand that. That's for their safety of their employees.
Yeah. So I went in, and so this was cool because this is the first time I've seen this. So I needed to get my new card, my new debit card. Usually they order it and it shows up, 5 to 10 days
later?
Ship
it to you, yeah.
They printed it right there. They have a machine. They put all the information in. The debit card prints out right there.
With a chip in it and everything?
Everything. Chip and everything.
Wow.
That was so interesting. I've never seen that before.
Me either.
So I got it while I was standing there waiting.
That's very cool.
So, oh, this is what I was going to tell you. This is something, you remember we were talking about. This is what I'm going to talk to you about.
What?
This is one of my just pet peeves.
Okay, what?
So I go to the bank,
uh-huh.
Right?
Uh-huh.
Pet peeve. This is my pet peeve.
I'm listening.
Big pet peeve. I go to the bank. I say, I need to get a new card. The guy says, okay. And I show him my old card. I said, I need this. So my name, Rick Baldwin,
mm-hmm.
on my card.
Mm-hmm.
On my account, it says Richard. Now, I don't use that. That's what my parents named me.
I know.
1 year of my life, I used that. I think I was in the fourth grade.
Right.
I wanted to be Richard. I don't know why. It's an experiment.
But I've go never by used... Rick.
So I've actually been, like, I've had to use my name, and they forced me to sign Richard.
Yep.
I don't know how to sign that. I can't sign it the way I sign my name.
I know.
It's just like someone else's name. So I give him my card, and it says Rick. He says, what name do you want? I was Rick. He says, well, I can't do that because that's not what the account is under.
But
it's under Richard.
Card, I was like, that you handed him,
I know,
from the same bank,
he
already
said,
says Rick.
Well,
on it.
Whoever did that was not supposed to do it. Did you have a friend? And I was like, no, that's just what they put on it. That's my name.
Yeah.
The account they forced me to put in my legal name. I don't want to, but I have to. Mm-hmm. But this is the name that I use. Well, I'm sorry, I can't do that.
Wow.
And so at that moment, I almost left, but I was just like, whatever, let's just get this over with. Give me a card with the friend, you know.
Sure. Wow.
So he puts all the information in, pushes the button. It comes out Rick Baldwin. He told me he couldn't do it, and then he freaking did it.
And then he did it.
I have been to so many banks where they'll be like, and I'll say, this charge was unauthorized. I need it taken off. I'm not unauthorized. I'll be like, I accidentally overdrawn or something. I don't know what it is.
Sure.
And they'll be like, no, I can't take that off. I can't take that charge off.
Right.
And I'll be like, why can't you? I've been in a bank before where they've done it. No, I can't do it.
But they actually can.
They can.
It depends on who you get, because I have a friend who a payment did not come through her bank account, so that when her automatic payments came out of her bank account, mm-hmm. it ended up charging her late or overdraft fees,
yep.
on each and every one of those auto payments.
Yes.
So she went to the bank or called the bank or whatever, and they were like, no, we can't do that.
Yeah.
And it was over $100 in non-sufficient fund fees.
Yeah.
So she got on like social media of some kind and was just tearing into them. And somebody on her social media worked at that bank,
mm-hmm.
not at that branch, but at that bank, and contacted her and says, if you want to call me, I will go in and we will fix this for you.
Yeah.
And they did it.
I had that same experience when I got married years ago, and I used an account accidentally that I thought I had closed or meant to close, and I used the wrong card.
Uh-huh.
And it took out of that, because I closed the account, and it took out of that, there wasn't anything in there. So it charged me like $700
oh my gosh.
Worth of insufficient fund things. And I go to the bank. The bank was like, no, we can't do that. The guy was like, I can't do it. I'm sorry. And I was like, this was an accident, obviously.
Right.
I closed this. No, I'm sorry. I can't do it.
That's bullshit.
So I, my wife was an attorney at the time. Mm-hmm. So she came back and said, we'd like to get them. The guy was like, sure, I could take care of that. Took every single one of them off.
Yep.
So I was like, the guy before you said it couldn't be done, and then now it's being done.
Yeah.
That's my pet peeve when somebody tells you they can't do something and then they do it.
What they mean is, I won't.
What they mean is, screw you.
Exactly. So it's like, if you tell me that's not possible, that can't be done.
Right.
But then I find out that it can. What you actually said to me was, I don't want to do this for you.
That's exactly what it is. And then it's like, one of my friends was like, he was buying, I don't know, a computer or a car. I don't remember what it was. And the person was just like, no, I can't give you that discount. I can't give you the discount. And he was like, why can't you give me the discount? And he was like, I can't give you the discount. And then it goes back and forth. And finally the guy was like, all right, I'll give you the discount.
So basically he didn't want to give him the discount.
And then the guy was like, thank you. Now I'm going to go shopping somewhere else. And he left because he was like, asshole. You could have done it, but you didn't do it.
Mm-hmm. You didn't want to.
That's my pet peeve right there. Thank you.
That's huge.
Thanks for letting me gripe a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. Anytime. Anytime you want to rant, you go to town.
Let's see. Watch some documentaries.
Yeah.
Finished up The Tiger King. I don't know. That's so overrated. You know, they're making a new one.
That's stupid.
It is. It's very stupid. And I watched the whole thing. I was interested. I watched 7 episodes. And one time is fine. Every one of those people should be in jail, in my opinion.
Yeah.
That's all I'm going to say. Not going to do a spoiler.
Okay.
I think they should just put them all away. but the sad thing is that they're all going to be, like, famous.
I know.
And I started thinking about that. It's like the same people that I see on Facebook posting these memes saying, stop making stupid people famous, are the same people who are posting Tiger King memes.
And making stupid people famous.
Quit.
Stop it.
Saw a great documentary called Bathtubs Over Broadway on Netflix, I believe.
Yeah.
I think it was Netflix. Watch it. That's so interesting.
Bathtubs Over Broadway.
And I'll just tell you a little bit about what it's about, but I'm not going to go into a lot of detail. But so back in the like 50s, 60s, and 70s, I think, maybe even before that, there was this, I won't say underground. It wasn't underground. But companies like Ford, Westinghouse, Mobil Oil, whatever. I mean, any company.
Mm-hmm.
For whatever reason, I don't know why they would do this, but they would hire, they would spend. Okay, so one person at one point, I think it was in the 60s, 50s or 60s, said that their budget was $3 million. Now, you think $3 million in the 50s.
That's a lot. Like a lot.
To create a musical, just like on Broadway, about their product.
A musical about their product? Like Mobil Oil?
An entire musical about air conditioners or plumbing supplies. It's the weirdest thing. So Bathtubs Over Broadway, and they would hire famous people. Like, you know Tony Randall from Odd Couple?
Yes.
He was in one of them. So they would, I mean, that's why they're so expensive. They would hire professionals. And these people, they're Broadway quality actors.
Absolutely.
The people who wrote Fiddler on the Roof wrote some of these. These are like top quality things. So, and no one saw them except the salespeople and the people who work for these companies.
Really?
And they actually produced albums, records of these performances, sometimes videos. The videos and movies are rare, but albums. So this guy who is a former comedy writer for David Letterman just got obsessed with these things. So he goes around collecting the albums.
Mm-hmm.
So Jello Biafra from is it Black Flag, I think, isn't that his band? Dead Kennedys. Who did Jello Biafra? Who was this?
I'm not gonna know.
One of those two. I can't remember right now. I want to say Dead Kennedys. But anyway, he collects all of these. There's these guys that are into punk music that collect these, and they have literally hundreds or thousands of these albums, and they trade them. So this guy from the Letterman show is obsessed with them, and he has a collection as well. And he could sing all of these songs.
What?
So he goes out and he actually starts meeting the people who did these.
Uh-huh.
He met the people who wrote these. And it's kind of an interesting, sweet thing, because these people whose work has been covered for years, now get to have some glory. But it's amazing. It's funny. It's cute. It's, my wife says it's just like the perfect documentary for quarantine.
Okay,
just,
I'm going to check it out.
It's a feel-good movie.
Bathtubs over Broadway.
Yeah.
What's the title mean?
Well, the bathtubs, there's like, you know, the plumbing supply company,
right,
or the people who make bathtubs or whatever. And it's kind of like a Broadway show. So Bathtubs Over Broadway. And it's, but anyway, watch it. You will really enjoy it. It's a lot of fun. So we got to watch that. That mm-hmm. was interesting.
Cool.
Let's see. Oh, before we go, I want to mention a YouTube channel.
Okay.
That I've been into.
Sure.
So I started doing a lot of sculpture recently. Mm-hmm. And one of my friends asked me to do a sculpture for her. And I was like, I don't do... You know, sculpting is not my...
It's not your forte.
It's not my forte, and it's not something I enjoy. All right?
Okay.
I don't like it, but I have to do it as part of my work.
For your job.
So she asked if I would do a sculpture for that she could give as a gift, and I was like, maybe, but not certainly not the way I do it. the styrofoam and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, no.
And I've been thinking about kind of doing some clay sculpture, getting into something like that.
Uh-huh.
That's a whole different area, but I've sort of been thinking about it. So I started doing some research and looking up some stuff on YouTube, and I found this guy does the most amazing sculptures, and I kind of want to promote his, and he doesn't need it. He's huge.
Okay, and what is his,
Ace of Clay.
Ace of Clay.
He uses polymer clay and creates some amazing artwork.
Okay.
And so look him up, Ace of Clay, and watch his stuff. It's just amazing to watch. And he does a lot of monsters and creatures and things like that. And it's just outstanding. Yeah, he's got an Instagram channel. But just watch the YouTube channel, because you get to watch from like beginning to end. It's
this is very cool.
It's incredible to watch.
So I just looked up his Instagram, folks, and this is some quality work here.
Yeah. And then I'm not taking away from him, watch him, but then there's another person named Juliana Lepine.
Mm-hmm.
Lepine. Man, her stuff, it looks like the person, photorealistic. Now, this guy's stuff is kind of cartoony and fun and,
right,
and fantasy. Her stuff, like she does a sculpture of Freddie Mercury. It looks like Freddie Mercury. She gets down into like the exact stuff.
So it looks like he's sitting there.
Juliana Lepine. L-A-P-I-N. What is that? Like means the rabbit, Lepine.
Okay.
It's French for the rabbit. Okay. Juliana Rabbit.
Juliana Rabbit.
But anyway, look at her stuff, but especially Ace of Clay. I've just kind of been getting into those a lot recently.
Cool. I'm going to check it out.
Do
for
so.
Sure. For sure. For sure.
All right. What you got? Anything?
Nothing, actually. I think we... let's call it.
All right. We got to talk about this brewski.
Yep.
Well, first of all, let's just, again, thank the people out there for listening to us. We asked people for if they want to get any stickers.
Yeah.
And we got some people who asked for stickers. I will say, too, we did get a letter, and I forgot to mention it. It was like a couple weeks ago. One of our listeners, and I don't know if I should mention his name.
Let's not.
He knows who he is.
Okay.
Did reply to the show we were doing about spas and sex workers. This is when Nurse CJ was here.
Right.
And I was like, why? How do they get away with stuff? So he sent me this website, and this girl, she's like a sex worker.
Mm-hmm.
She works in a massage parlor. She works in a spa.
Okay.
And she talks about all of the stuff that happens. It's very graphic,
but
very interesting. And I can't remember the name of it. I don't know that I'm not sure if I want to give the information out. But it is there, and it talked a little bit about how legally they get away with doing the spa stuff.
That's interesting.
If you want to know it, you can send us an email at thisepicdisaster@gmail.com. I'll try to send you the link. I just don't know if I want to say it on the air, because it's very graphic. I mean, it talks about, you know, what they do in the spas.
Sure.
So, but anyway, I want to thank our listener for sending that in, because it did help. It talked a little bit about how they get away with it legally. And you can read all of that kind of stuff.
Okay, so hit us up at thisepicdisaster@gmail.com or send us a link or send us a note on Facebook Messenger or whatever.
Yeah.
And we'll be happy to send you that link if you want to check it out.
And come and join us on Facebook. Join us on the Disaster Baiters group. Occasionally, we'll do some special videos there.
Sometimes.
And, you know, I feel like I'm doing it. I'm doing it right now. Let's think of a phrase. I know what the phrase is.
Okay.
What
are we talking about?
We're going to do a phrase. We haven't done a phrase in a while.
Oh, gosh, you're right.
This needs to be a phrase. All right, so I'm sorry if you've won in the past. You cannot win this time. All right? This needs to be a new winner. All right?
Okay.
A new phrase. This is the phrase. I have to go spackle the rhino.
I have to go...
Spackle the rhino.
Spackle the rhino.
I had to do that this week, and I had to say that to my wife, and then I realized this sounded really dirty. But I did have to spackle the rhino.
I'll spackle your rhino.
If you are the first person to say that or post that phrase on Facebook... You cannot have won before. Please don't play if you've won before.
What if they've won and they never got their gift because I haven't sent it to them yet?
No, you have to send them that gift.
Okay.
But if you have not won before, you put that on Facebook and you're the first person, we will send you a This Epic Disaster T-shirt.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah, it's been a while since we've sent out a T-shirt, so we'll do that.
All right. But it has to be someone who hasn't won one of these phrase things before.
That's correct.
Okay.
And only a few people have.
That's true. But we only have a few listeners. So.
Right. but yeah, you can find us on Instagram. You can find us on YouTube. You can find us on Twitter.
All those places.
Yeah.
We'll be there.
We'll be hanging out.
We'll
All right.
Be
let's
here.
Talk about this brewski. What do you think of the brewski?
I mean, I've drank more of mine than you have of yours.
Yeah.
Mostly just out of thirst.
Mm-hmm.
Again, it's a fine IPA.
Fine if you like IPAs.
It's a fine IPA. It's actually rather refreshing. Mm-hmm. It's not terribly hoppy.
Mm-hmm.
It is hoppy because it's an IPA, but it's not overly hoppy.
Okay.
It's also not in my. I mean, it does have a lot of citrus.
Yeah, it's one of those that tastes like you're drinking grapefruit juice and. I've said that before on the show, and some people have written in and said, that's what I like in a beer.
Exactly.
And so that's great.
Yeah.
Then this is a beer you need to go buy.
Yep. You need to go buy this beer.
Who was the brewery?
You took the can from me.
The brewery. I don't.
The brewery is the Burnt Hickory Brewery out of Kennesaw, Georgia.
Oh, it's local.
Yeah. So
okay.
It's just up the road.
Okay. But it just tastes like grapefruit juice.
I mean,
it's as sweet.
It's got citrus, that's for sure. It's got some citrus.
If I have to give it a number and we rate 1 out of 5, 5 being the best, 1 being the worst,
mm-hmm.
You have actually, I think you rated a beer below 1.
I think I did too.
One time.
I don't remember. We'd have to ask Aaron.
It was
Aaron.
When we did Budweiser.
Oh, yes, that's it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to rate this one. I'm probably going to go ahead and give it a 2.5 because as far as IPAs go, it's not bad.
Mm-hmm.
And again, this is coming from someone that does not like IPAs.
Right.
So please remember the things that we said specifically about it. It's very citrusy. It's not overly hoppy. So if those are things you like, check it out. For me, 2.5.
I'm giving it a 2.
Okay.
So we're kind of in the same league. You like it a little better more than I do. It's just too grapefruity for me. So that's what we're saying this week. We're going to shut down. Please, people, keep in touch with us. Take care of yourself. Make sure you're doing the social distancing. It's not going to last that much longer. It's not. We're already doing it. We're already seeing the numbers improve. But keep listening to us. Share the podcast. Tell your friends. We really like it when you hang out with us. And just drop a line on the Facebook or something. Say hi.
Somewhere.
Let us know what's going on with you, how you're doing. We still would like to hear some of your quarantine stories.
Sure.
What are you doing? What's happening? Anything exciting? Anything interesting happen? How are you keeping yourself occupied during this time? We'll talk. We'll read it. You know, send it to us through email. We'll read it on the air.
There's an interesting article that I didn't get a chance to read yet, but basically it was a person who got a new roommate 2 days before self-isolation.
Oh, no.
Yeah. And so now they're like really having to get to know each other.
Wow. That would be weird. Well, tell us some stories and we'd like to share them with people. But in the meantime, take care of yourself. Stay in touch. And listen to our show every week at Monday. We'll be there.
And please remember to get up, go outside, move your body, mm-hmm. stimulate your mind,
yeah.
and just stay safe.
That's right.
Okay.
All right. We'll see you next week.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye.
This is a Violet Jester Media Podcast.